This program was first broadcast on Canterbury's community access radio station Plains FM 96.9 and was made with the assistance of New Zealand On Air.
It's time for Emergence News on Plains FM 96.9, citizen-made radio.
Greetings, kia ora, and welcome to Emergence News. My name's Nigel and it's my pleasure to be with you on Emergence News. This edition is focused on Maitreya and his emergence. And joining me on the program today are my fellow producers and presenters on the program, Peter and John. Hi, guys.
G'day, Nigel.
Hello, Peter.
Hi there.
Okay, that's the welcomes and the formalities sorted. According to esoteric literature, Maitreya is not only the coming Buddha, the fifth, he is the one that is looked for by all the world's major religions. So this demands that today we look at who Maitreya is. Mm-hmm. Who is he? His identity, his history. This edition of Emergence News is titled Maitreya Questions and Answers. So we're going to ask John and Peter a number of questions so that we can delve a little deeper and find out who Maitreya is, his presence and emergence. It's been predicted by many, and no one can deny, John, that we're living in extraordinary times at the moment. The corruption, the despair, the confusion in politics and economics and society.
I think we're starting to get a look at the bottom of the barrel, aren't we? We're starting to see what competition and greed have delivered for us as a race and as a planet and as an environment and as an economy.
That's pretty disgusting too.
And there's not a lot of good stuff at the bottom of the barrel. So we need to be doing something different.
Yes, we need something to happen. And we suggest to you that there is, in fact, something amazing afoot. And the name Maitreya is at the heart of it. According to Benjamin Krem, the late Benjamin Krem, and we refer to Benjamin Krem frequently on this program, the story of Maitreya is the single most important event of our age and, in fact, offers hope. This story offers hope in a time of increasing chaos. Mm-hmm. So I'm going to ask John and Peter some questions regarding Maitreya. And Peter, I'd like to put to you today, if somebody was listening to this program for the first time and they'd never heard of Maitreya, for example, is he a god? Is he an avatar? Is he a teacher? Who is Maitreya?
Well, of course, he is. He holds the office of the Christ, but he is, as you say, the fifth Buddha. And the Buddhists await him as the fifth Buddha. And in fact, Gautama 2,500 years ago predicted his coming again. Mm-hmm. And also, he is the teacher for all mankind and for all religions and none, mainly. I mean, most of the world perhaps has lost religion, and maybe that's a good thing. But, you know, some of the religions have been so dogmatic and so pushing people in the wrong direction and too much hellfire and brimstone. And Maitreya brings in this sensibility and also a reality to people that they can, I mean, what he's asking people is to be happy, actually. Mm-hmm. And he's come to show us the way to God, and that's, you know, how simple is that?
It's almost like an update, isn't it? It's like humanity's software and the planet's hardware, and Maitreya has come to give us an upgrade on the way we approach things, the way we look at life, the way we look at each other, the way we look at our role within the hardware of planet Earth.
And also asking us to do something which we don't always find very easy, and that is look at ourselves and understand ourselves better.
And the hard thing he's asking us to do is share. Mm. And I think a lot of people are struggling, in the Western world particularly, to share.
Yes, because some cultures find that easier than others.
Absolutely.
If you've got nothing, it's easier to share.
Yes.
If you've got a lot, hang on a minute.
If you've acquired a considerable amount, yes.
Yeah.
From an astrological perspective, John,
yes,
why is Maitreya emerging now?
I guess I'm going to pick up from where Peter's come from. the existence of great spiritual teachers, and I've got this this information off the Share International website, really became public knowledge about 1875 through the writings of Helena Blavatsky, founder of the Theosophical Society. She worked directly with the masters. And what's come out of that story is that periodically at times of great human crisis, the masters or the teachers send one of their own into the world. We know some of these teachers as Krishna, Confucius, Zoroaster, the Buddha, the Christ, Muhammad. Now, near the end of World War II, Maitreya, who's the head of the spiritual hierarchy for this planet, and every planet has a spiritual hierarchy, and they communicate with each other. Maitreya announces intention to physically enter the everyday world at the earliest possible moment, along with a group of these masters. So from an astrological perspective, there's a couple of things pushing this emergence. One is, it's the age. He is the teacher for the age of Aquarius. And since, I think, 1625 or 1645, Peter, we've been
1625.
We've been entering the ocean of energy that is generated by the constellation of Aquarius. So spaceship Earth is in a flotilla of other spaceships, and we're moving through greater space. And currently, we're bathing in the energies of the constellation of Aquarius, which shapes life on this planet.
So what's happening to the energies of the age of Pisces?
Drifting away. It's actually in the exhaust of our spaceship. It's actually blowing away out the back as we go forward into...
And that, how is that revealing itself on the planet at the moment?
Well, there's a lot of it still polluting, isn't it?
Well, that's a rearguard action. The forces of Pisces, the attitudes that Pisces brought, which is, I'm all right, Jack, and that individualization and...
It was a necessary state.
Yes.
But the time has passed.
Yeah. We've gone from developing me to sharing me. We have to have a strong personality so you can work in a group. So Pisces was humanity developing that strong individualized personality. But now you need to take that into group work, and you need to wind it back sometimes. So the age, he's here for this age. Secondly,
and he's going to be here for a while.
2,500 years. So the oracle's not going to go away. He's going to be with us in a physical body for 2,500 years.
So that's going to be very different from the message from Jesus of Nazareth 2,000 years ago, where his story, his teachings got, let's say, distorted.
Mutilated.
Well, look, and
that's not going to happen with my
trust. Well, technology. If you want to hear what Benjamin Cream's got to say, go to YouTube and you'll see Benjamin Cream talking. And so back in Jesus' day, there wasn't a technology. He could only speak to people he'd get in front of. So what was left was with normal people writing down what he said and interpreting it. We won't have that problem because Maitreya can speak to a worldwide audience, and once he makes his full appearance, he's accessible to everybody. So technology is going to help. There is an element of karma and an element of timing. Cosmic and planetary karma, to a certain degree, have an effect on his ability to appear. But it is in accord with the plan. The masters have always been coming back around this time into everyday life of humanity. They've been in the background for 98,000 years. And then finally, what's the big picture? It's an appeal. 1945, humanity expressed a fairly unified appeal for help because suffered. People suffered after 1945, after the Second World War, fairly equally right across the globe. So there was this heartfelt appeal, which Maitreya, as head of the spiritual hierarchy on this planet and the Christ for this planet, is duty-bound to respond to.
More on Maitreya questions and answers in just a moment. Welcome back to Emergence News, Maitreya questions and answers. Peter, could you give us a bit more history regarding Maitreya, his journey from a human being to a master to the esteemed position he now holds?
Yes, well, he was actually one of the first to initiate to the third initiation back in the mid-Atlantean times, and together with the Buddha. But of course, the Buddha actually came from a previous system. So Maitreya was the first, and became the Christ because he was the first
of this planet.
Of this planet. In fact, he is our eldest brother. And he portrays himself as that, doesn't he?
Peter, when Krem talks about Maitreya and the Buddha being brothers, does he mean brothers, as in from the same family line, or does he mean brothers in that bigger...
In the bigger sense, bigger, I think, because, you know, the fact that the Buddha came from the, I think from the moon chain, but it may have been from another planetary chain.
Oh, okay.
Yes.
Wow.
Jesus was and still is known as Jesus Christ. Mm-hmm. How and when did Jesus of Nazareth become known as Jesus Christ?
Well, he wasn't born Jesus Christ. He was born Jesus, and he was Christed, and the church will vouch for this as well, over the last 3 years of his ministry. And then when the Christ was actually overshadowing him, and at times he actually took over his body with Jesus' permission, and it was all done, with his assent, of course, but he was on a mission and knew it. He knew that this was his role.
And a fourth degree initiate at the time.
Yes, well, he became fourth degree initiate on the cross. Mm-hmm. He demonstrated the crucifixion, or the great renunciation.
Mm-hmm. Okay, so what you've just said there is really interesting, Peter, because you're saying from the age of 30 to 33, he was overshadowed by the Christ. We're talking about Maitreya, aren't we?
Yes, we are.
Now, is that an isolated incident, or has Maitreya overshadowed other teachers?
Definitely, yes. I mean, Shankara, he overshadowed, and Krishna as well. And it's the method par excellence of a master talking to a disciple. He will overshadow him, just as Benjamin Krem was overshadowed by the Christ when he gave the messages out. Maitreya gave 140 messages through Benjamin Krem and overshadowed him each time, and put those words into his mind. He was not able to say anything else other than that. Altered his voice so that when you listen to him, his voice is definitely different from Benjamin Krem. And altered his breathing at the same time. So the whole program is, you know, has been done right throughout history. The overshadowing is done by a master to a disciple. And you know, this is the way that it will continue, I guess, until we all become masters.
I'd love to overshadow you, Peter. I think you'd make a great disciple.
John, the masters of wisdom, we've heard, Peter's already spoken of the masters of wisdom, the spiritual hierarchy. Who are they?
It's a really good question. And I really kind of struggled with this because there are kind of a number of different stories, if you like. So I've gone to the website, the Share International website, and I cannot stress enough for our listeners, Share Magazine, Share International website, everything today I've got off that Share website.
And that's getting upgraded shortly too.
Well, it actually was a bit easier to use today when I was looking at some stuff. So yeah, that's great. Who are they? Well,
who are the masters of wisdom?
Yeah, I kind of went back to the outstanding quality of the energy of Aquarius is synthesis. So then I went to spiritual hierarchy, who are they? And I came up with a little bit of a definition. The masters of wisdom, together forming the spiritual hierarchy, are the custodians of the divine plan for this planet. They have inspired all the great human achievements, working from behind the scenes through their disciples. And that's the process that Peter was talking about in every field of human endeavor.
Overshadowing and empowering
and key
people on our planet through our history.
Yep, they guide and teach, but humanity only responds through its free will. That's the golden rule, really, is that idea of free will, which in current planet Earth, we're not great with free will. In fact, we tend to teach the opposite. We tend to teach manipulation.
Yes, we bash people who sort of want to exercise agree with their free will.
Yeah, yes. And advertising's manipulation and so on and so on. We have very little free will practice, so it's difficult to talk to people about, but it's the golden rule.
Can I just interrupt there? When you talk about free will, so you're saying that the spiritual hierarchy, the masters of wisdom, Maitreya, there is a level of influence that they cannot cross. There's a line they can't cross because of our divine right for free will.
Absolutely. And that is what makes humanity divine. And that's what gives us that spark of equality, because Maitreya can look at each individual human on this planet and know there's only certain things he can do.
To help us.
To help us, to be involved in our lives.
There's only so far he can go.
Yes.
And that's what he means when he says it is up to us to begin to implement the changes that are necessary.
Mm. I think he uses the phrase, the architect and we the builders. That's kind of the idea that he has a plan and some great ideas, and how we implement that is up to us. Mm. And this is what many critics of religion and the state of the planet don't understand. It is not God doing this to us. God's not involved in child slavery. We are. God's not involved in pollution. We are. It's human free will that has made the mess. And it's the advice from the spiritual hierarchy that will show us a better way of doing it. So they've been around forever. As Peter's pointed out, some of the other teachers that we'll know, some of the other avatars, if you like, Krishna, Buddha, Confucius, Jesus, and Muhammad. Some of those, their teaching gives birth to a new religion. I don't think that's been always the way, but that is often how cultures following a teacher have condensed or packaged their ideas is in the form of a religion.
Maitreya is not bringing or establishing a new religion this time, though, is it?
Let's face it, there's enough of them here already.
Yeah. And, you know, I think a religion will come out of Maitreya's teachings for sure. But no, he doesn't come to start a new religion. He comes with ideas.
We're back in just a few moments with more questions and answers regarding Maitreya.
This is the Emergence News on Plains FM. For more information, go to shareinternational.org.
Welcome back to Emergence News. This edition, this program is titled Maitreya Questions and Answers. And just before we move into the area of the emergence of Maitreya, Peter, I've got a question for you. It's one that we get asked often, and the Share International, there's been questions from readers over the years asking, in regard to the Masters of Wisdom, why are there only male masters?
Well, it's the energies that they bring in. They're very much spiritual in nature at the moment. And so the masters are hermaphrodites, if you like. In other words, there's no difference as far as they're concerned. There may well have been women, all of them, of course, have been women and men throughout their incarnations. And so it's an energetic thing. It's basically to do. The women are more basically like Earth Mother, like more the material aspects. At the moment, they're wanting to focus on their spiritual aspects, and the men are better at bringing in that energetic, they have a better physical body to bring in that energetic spiritual energy.
And I think Krem says in one of his books, John, that the first master to embody a female body will be Mother Mary, and it'll be in about 450 years. So it's going to take a wee bit longer.
Yeah, one of the things I read that Krem said too is that the planet's still primitive, and that we won't have female masters until we step up a bit. But I did read recently that the planet itself is still in its female energetic form, so the masters to kind of balance that are coming through in apparently male energetic structures. So there's quite a strong balancing relationship there. But that'll change as we progress and as that energetic balance changes.
The emergence of Maitreya, John, declaring his presence openly to the world, why is this such a gradual process?
You know, it's a difficult one, and I guess, Peter, when I think about it, it's more about free will. There's an element of he can't rush out, that he has to be asked to come forward. Mm. There's an element of timing around world events, and also the forces of materialism are fighting a very tough rearguard action, so that he's being blocked at every step of the way. So it's a process that takes some time to unfold.
You're right. The lords of materiality are really, and their disciples, the materialists of the world, are putting up a real tough regard action.
Yeah. So he's been hampered by elements on the planet. He's awaiting for that window to step forward. Humanity has to ask and has to be practicing to a degree the element of sharing and the element of peace, so that that will form the timing. I guess the other thing too that we've heard over the years, Peter, is tied to this collapse of the financial institutions.
Yes, I mean, he's mentioned that quite often, hasn't he? That, you know, once that collapse comes about, and a lot of the economists know it's coming.
Absolutely.
You know, it's just a matter of time, and no one can actually, you know, give us the time, but it will happen, and that will suddenly make people stop and scratch their head and, well, what do we do now?
Exactly. And it's that question.
That point, and that's a poignant point.
Yes.
That humanity it'll bring in that crisis.
Yeah. Yeah.
And part of the emergence process, which was rather obvious, when did Maitreya actually physically reappear and take on a physical form?
Well, it was back in 77 that he came down. He was in a physical form, but probably at an etheric level, but he took on and created his own physical body that we can see and we can relate to. I think this is the thing, but if we look at the photograph of him when he appeared in Kenya, he looks about 6 foot tall. And
Syrian body?
Yes, it's in a Maravipta, and it's basically a body of illusion, Maya being illusion, and it looks like a physical body, but it's not. He's doesn't need to eat or sleep or drink or anything like that. He can't be killed. He'll be here for the next 2,500 years. So it's a body of illusion.
So what Peter's just said has explained why it's such a gradual process, because that's a lot, what Peter's just said, that's a lot to get your head around when you've heard it for the first time.
I think that's absolutely a key ingredient, because he can't infringe our free will, and nor does he want to scare us.
Exactly.
And at the moment we are...
It's pretty profound what Peter just said.
Absolutely. And that's why I often, when Peter comes in the room, I stand up.
When did that happen?
Okay, here we go. Here we go. I'm standing up. It's that ability to know when the timing's right, sense when that appeal from humanity is strongest, but also not infringe our free will or scare us. We're already knee deep in fear. Mm. You know, we don't need that from the Christ.
John, to finish the program today, I'm not quite sure how long we've got, but not long, so we'll just make a start. Could you give us some obvious examples of the emergence process? So we're talking about Maitreya and the emergence process, the externalization of the spiritual hierarchy and Maitreya himself. For example, the crosses of light.
Look, there's been any...
unexplained phenomena.
Yes, any number of phenomena. The hand of Maitreya, healing waters, the star that's hovering over the planet, crosses of light, circles of light.
I remember back in the 1990s, there were the Hindu statues.
Milk statues.
Yes.
Producing milk. Mm. But look, the two things that I'm asking listeners to look for, the two predictions by Maitreya, are young people and voice of the people. So we're seeing voice of the people, Hong Kong, 1.7 million people in the streets, and young people are coming up with the answers. Greta Thunberg, there's any number of young people. So those two predictions that Maitreya has said, look for...
the young ones.
Yeah, the young ones coming through who are ready for this age, and also that voice of the people shaking off the oligarchy that's managed this planet so far.
Yes, those are some of the obvious examples. And in regard to the environment, of course, it's very obvious that there are so many young ones coming through, Peter. They're very clear. We can't continue to plunder the planet the way we have been.
Oh, that's right. And, you know, we can even see they're talking about sharing, which, of course, is the major focus of Maitreya, sharing the world's resources. And, I mean, our magazine, Share International, is exactly about that.
Absolutely. All this information can be found on the Share International website, www.share-international.org. Scorpio Books in Christchurch carries the magazine and some books. And also don't forget the podcasts, which are available on the Plains FM website.
We welcome your comments, questions and feedback. Please contact us at emergencenews@gmail.com.
The opportunity to join our transmission is available Monday and Wednesday evenings and Thursday mornings, which gives us the possibility to do a service meditation in conjunction with Masters.